Hey y'all, this is Dierks Bentley, and I want to thank Kip Moore and Kenneth Smith for being part of this historic event. This is the first ever Bobby Bones Ask Anything chat, ever. And I'm going to answer some questions for you guys. Thanks for having me. All right, you guys, here we go, the first ever Bobby Bones Ask Anything chat. I got some questions here from listeners, and I'm going to go through them. So this first one's from Brittany from Lewistown. What is one of your most memorable moments at a show? That's really easy. Last year on our Riser tour, we were playing in Pennsylvania, and I'm not going to name names, but there was some fans dressed as flight attendants out there in the crowd, and I brought them up on stage, and I think it was out of pure stage fright, but one of them did throw up on the stage. Kind of sounded a lot like that truck that just drove by. No, I'm kidding. But she did throw up on stage, and I felt really bad. It was funny at the time, but I felt really bad for her, and actually found a way to get her number, and I've left her a couple messages. Telling her that I hope she's recovered from it, and her friends have not given her too much grief about it, because it will forever be one of my most favorite memories ever of touring. So thank you to whoever you are. You know who you are. And I hope that answers your question. Brittany, question. Let's see here. Next one is from John from Charlotte. How will your shows this summer be different from your past shows? John, we put a lot of time into every tour. I mean, we spend months. Even when we're on one tour, we start thinking about the next tour and like, how can we keep what's good about this tour, but take it up to a new level or change it in some way that makes it better, or keeps always trying to improve it. And then we come back to Nashville and we spend a lot of months just doing rehearsals and getting it all ready to go. So, I mean, obviously it starts with who's out there with us. This year having Kip Moore, who just arrived by train. Kenneth Smith is going to be awesome. Maddie and Tay. So just having that different energy changes up the tour by having different folks out there. But last year, Drunk on a Plane was still developing. Now it's a pretty big hit, so that'll be a big part of the show. I Held On has done the same. Say You Do, getting those songs up front in the show. Production-wise, we've got some new things we're bringing out there with us. We always put a lot of money back into the tour just to try to make it a little bit bigger than the year before. So this is a long way of saying that I really can't tell you. It's going to be a surprise. You're just going to have to come out to the show and see. But just know that we put a lot of time into it. We want it to be the best show you see all summer long. And there's a lot of competition out there, so that's a lofty goal, but we put a lot into it. Thanks, John from Charlotte. Looking forward to playing there this year. This next one is from Nava from Grantsville. I'm not sure where Grantsville is, but it sounds like a cool town. What is your favorite song that you like to sing live when you're on tour? Such a hard question to answer, because I do love singing them all. Whatever the current single is always fun to watch that song kind of grow out there on the road. You start doing that song before people really know it that well, then it goes, the album comes out and people know it a little bit better, then it gets on the radio and it starts to get a lot more exposure and starts getting louder and louder coming back to us. So seeing how Say You Do that does the summer on the road will be great. I mean, Drunk on a Plane is a really crazy fun moment in the show, so that's there's that for the party aspect of it. Riser definitely is an emotional song to sing every night and really feel a connection with the crowd on that song. So in some way they all are, but it just, I feel really blessed to have a show full of songs that I love singing. So I'd love to hear what you think is your favorite song. But thanks, Nava from Grantsville. If that answered your question. Nicole from St. Johnsville. I don't know where that is, but it sounds like a great town too. What's the craziest thing a fan has done to get your attention that I can mention on the Bobby Bones Ask Anything chat? This year, just with Drunk on a Plane being the song that it was, seeing guys out there like dressed as pilots, girls dressed as pilots, girls dressed as flight attendants, guys dressed as flight attendants, kind of saw a lot of crazy things out there on the road this summer. So it's one thing when you guys like sing songs back to us, and that is amazing, but to see someone actually dress for the show wearing a certain a costume like that, it's always really special just to think that someone actually took the time to dress up for the show. So just seeing y'all out there. I got several shows in mind that I saw fans dress that particular way, but definitely got my attention and a lot of my appreciation. So thanks, Nicole from St. Johnsville.
Good marketing.
Adrian from Winston-Salem. What's up, Adrian? How are you doing? I have a feeling I know which Adrian this is. After 10, 12 years of doing this, I kind of get to know a lot of you all by name and location, and I know an Adrian in Winston-Salem. Love the title track of your album, Riser. What does being a riser mean to you? You know, I just think about people that are going through the, you know, daily struggles of just getting by and somehow finding a way to do it all. Be a parent, be a mom, be a dad, go to work, try to do the best they can in everything they do, and no matter what hardships life sends their way, they find a way to motivate themselves to get back and get up and get going every day. So it could be anybody. It doesn't have to be someone special, just someone that's making it happen for their family every day. That person to me is a riser. So that song is, you know, deeply personal to me and a big part of this album. And I think you are a riser. And look forward to seeing you out there on the road this summer. Thanks, Adrian. This next one's from Katie from British Columbia, the BC area. I have heard many stories by country artists like Chad Brownlee and Kip Moore with the pranks you have pulled. What is the best prank that someone has pulled on you? Chad Brownlee came out during the middle of one of our shows up there, dressed in full hockey gear, him and all the guys in his band and crew, and started having a hockey game on stage while we were playing. They had like tennis balls and they were firing tennis balls back and forth while we were trying to play a show. Was that me on him?
That was you.
That was me on him. That was the best prank. The guy, it all blended together because they started picking up hockey sticks too. The best one was pulled on me. Recently I walked out of a writing appointment and Kip Moore had had some people like spray paint my truck with I'm to Blame, his current single, I'm to Blame, all this side. And they filled the middle of the truck up with like my truck itself up with like all those peanuts, those packing peanuts. But the kicker was there was a live goat that had been using the restroom in the bed of my truck. And there's hay mixed with all that stuff in the back of my truck. So that was extreme. And there'll be definitely be some payback for that. But currently Kip has the best prank award so far for his I'm to Blame prank campaign. So thanks, Katie. See you up there in BC later this year. This next one's from Chelsea from Appleton, and she asks, do you plan to collaborate with any of the opening acts on the summer tour? For me, as a fan of going to concerts as a kid, I love seeing it when all the bands, all the different singers got a chance to get together at some point during the show. It's just fun to see everyone out there having a good time. So yeah, we're looking, still thinking about ways to incorporate Maddie and Tay and Kanan and Kip into the show somehow, whether it's on a, you know, some sort of one of my songs, one of their songs, a cover song, or even other ideas, I don't know. We try to find ways to really get everyone involved, and I just think it's exciting as a fan to see them, the other acts come back out there with the headliner. So, still brainstorming to think of ways, but yeah, definitely on the stage and then off the stage, you know, trying to write some songs. With all these guys, they're all great songwriters, so certainly be hanging around. We're not, drinking some beer, so we'll be thinking about trying to write some songs too, so. Can't wait to get out with all these guys. It's going to be a really, really fun tour on the Sounds of Summer tour. So thanks, Chelsea, for the question. This is Missy from Hattiesburg. Where do you look for inspiration when writing music? I just look at, you know, my own life, really. Just try to look at things that I'm going through, whether, you know, different phases of my life. I can always go back and draw on that stuff, the memories, whether it's a heartache, broken heart, or funny stuff, or now, you know, being a dad and just the emotions that draws up. So just looking into my own life and trying to find ways to write about that in a way that translates to, that's personal to me, but still becomes universal to my audience. So just looking around at regular things. And if you listen to country music, there's a lot of songs that start with just a really simple observational kind of line. You're trying to write songs, which maybe this question's about. It could just be the simplest line that starts a song and that, you know, builds into something bigger. You don't have to start with some really crazy, super inspirational thing. You can just start with just everyday life, and that's really what country music's about. So my only advice would be just to write as much as you can. So thanks, Missy. Thanks for that question. This next one's from Jessica from London. Could be Canada, could be England. If you were organizing your own music festival, who'd be the first five artists you would call? I'd just call my friends. I'd call guys I love and girls I love touring with. Probably call Luke up. It'd be fun to do a tour with Luke. Thomas Rhett would be fun to go on tour with. The guys I have right now, Kip Moore, Maddie and Tay, they're going to be a lot of fun to tour with, I think, my first time. Lady A, love all those guys. Gosh, who else? Maybe bring some bluegrass music out there, too. Maybe I'd bring, the Del McCurry Band. That'd be pretty cool to be on tour with the Del McCurry Band every day. So just bring out some friends. It's always fun playing music. You know, that's the best part of the day. But the other 23 hours are important, too. So just trying to be around people that you like and enjoy spending time with. And those folks I mentioned are people that I love. So this next one's from Kristen from Ottawa. Your most prized possession, what does it mean to you? Probably my guitar. I have this, you know, a 1993, or 97, sorry, Martin guitar, and it's really beat up. I got it when it was fairly new, and since then I put holes in it from my fingers running back over the top of it, and it's got a lot of dents, a lot of scratches, a lot of autographs around the outside from people like Merle Haggard, George Strait, George Jones, and tons of autographs from different friends, people I respect in the music business, so yeah, definitely that guitar, and you can see it every night when I play, because I'm still playing that same one, so. Come check us out. Carolyn from Houston asked, how did the empowering song Riser come about as a title track? So that song was a song I did not write. Steve Moeckler and Travis Meadows wrote that song, and it was presented to me, and I just fell in love with that song. I really felt like it encapsulated a moment in my life that I was going through there when I was writing this record with some stuff I was going through personally, and it became kind of the cornerstone of the record. And gosh, everything kind of revolved around that song as we continue to make the album. And it's a special, special song. I'm glad you love it. And I'm glad I found it. Hank from Hayward asks, how do you balance life as a country singer and a family man in the demands of this career? It's a big balancing act. It really is. Just trying to, I feel like I'm constantly trying to fill up cups that have holes in the bottom of them. You know, just going back and forth between music and everyone in my family individually and together, and just trying to find time for everybody. And it's just a matter of priorities and kind of cutting out things that maybe something you used to love to do, but you know, going out on a Tuesday night, probably don't do that anymore. But just find ways to keep it simplified as much as possible and just spend as much time with the things that matter the most. And I'm still trying to figure it out. So Hank, if you got a blueprint or something of how to do it, I will be listening, because it's a moving target. I feel like I can never get it perfectly right, but I'm always working on it. Y'all, that's it, all the questions, and I just want to say again, thanks to Bobby Bones for letting me be part of the first ever Ask Anything chat. Let me warm up the fans for our Sounds of Summer tour, and appreciate you guys. Always feels good to be the first, so thank you to Mr. Bobby Bones, and thanks to all our fans. Love you guys.